Hello, everybody. Joel Colander here again for Rock Island Auction Company. You notice we are still in the preview hall, and as we like to do on these auction days, we like to show you something that's coming up on the next day of auction, because there are just standout things on all 3 days. You can place bids all 3 days. There's inevitably going to be highlights that either didn't get a blog or a video or didn't get coverage. Bear with some of our background noise. We are in the preview hall, not on a sound stage. So for day two, we usually select one item, but for day two, there's just knockouts. I couldn't pick one. So what I wanted to pick essentially are holy grails, for lack of a better term. And I know the plural term holy grail is already kind of like, it's a singular term, right? So call them unicorns, call them holy grails. Fight about it in the comments however you want to, like what they should be called, after you subscribe, of course. But I want to go over some of these guns, these unicorns, these holy grails that I can see from right here. To my left, a Singer M1911 A1 pistol. And if you know the history with Singer M1911 A1 pistols, you know there's 500 made for World War II. Singer did not get the contract for 500,000 pistols because the government needed them for more precise work on, say, Norden bomb sites and the like. And that those of those 500 that were issued, very few returned because they were issued to pilots, which unfortunately had a very high rate of attrition. So Singer 1911 pistols are kind of the king of 1911 pistols. We have a world record Singer that sold for $414,000. They are extremely desirable, to say the least. Singer 1911 is a holy grail of 1911 collecting. Next is some of the Rolexes, actually, and fine timepieces we have in the auction are some of the Smith & Wesson, which have been embellished by Tiffany & Company. There's three in the sale. These, again, are still coming out of the Gerald Class collection. If you've been paying attention to some of the last videos that we've made and over the last few auctions, this Gerald Class collection has just been a mountain of significant Smith & Wesson. So, of course, he's going to have those embellished by Tiffany & Company. In fact, many of those in the Metropolitan Museum of Art are those that have either been gifted or on loan from the Dr. Gerald Class collection. So here we have Tiffany & Company, Smith & Wesson's, high art, American, like Art Nouveau. They're a holy grail for Smith & Wesson collectors. Now, we're going to take a quick walk so we can see some of these, but even those before we walk that you can't see have holy grail names are in this preview hall. There's a Colt Walker, and it's a Confederate Walker, no less. Like, Confederate arms don't survive, and Colt Walkers don't either, but here you have a Walker, a Confederate Walker that survives, and it's in this preview hall. That's absolutely boggling. There's a Texas Patterson, a Colt Patterson. Texas Patterson, the most desirable, is in this auction hall. Come on along, we'll take a look at a few of the other ones. In this case here, another holy grail for a Winchester collector is the Winchester 1 of 1000. This one's an 1873 1 of 1000. Extra cool part. So when the movie Winchester 73 came out, the movie studio had a contest where if you had a Winchester 1 of 1000 and you called the studio and notified them, they would send you, or they awarded so many Winchester Model 94s to those people. This is one of those Winchester 94s. It pairs with that Winchester Model 1873, 1 of 1,000. This one's the carbine. It comes with the documentation. It comes with the factory letter. Like, these two guns are linked. So this is the true holy grail, the Winchester 1 of 1,000. To have it attached to the movie that really gave it its popularity, and one of very, very few that are around, is just beyond cool for Winchester collectors. Take another step back. Oh, a holy grail for World War II collectors, or Class III collectors, or German military collectors. Take your pick. It's the FG-42, the Fallschirmjäger-Gewehr 42. And this is, now we've sold a couple before. We've sold some Type 2s. They tend to reach right around that $300,000 mark. This is a rare Type 1, and you can tell from that swept back handle. What you can't tell is it's a forged receiver instead of stamped. It has stamped parts, and later receivers were stamped. This one's forged. Just an absolute monster of World War II gun, instantly recognizable, affected so much afterward, including the M60. We have a quick video on this already up on our YouTube channel. So if you're watching there, go ahead and click that link, and you'll get to see the whole thing. More holy grails. Follow me. because they're all around. A Broadwell drum on top of a Gatling, like Broadwell drums, really rare. Not necessarily in Holy Grail status, but still really cool. Yes, I'm going to walk right past the Hotchkiss revolving cannon and come to a Gardner gun. Now, when you talk about cool and you talk about rare, you talk about unusual, the Gardner gun is up there. Sort of after the Gatling gun, a little too late to compete with the Gatling gun. And as you know, even Gatling saw limited service because they were soon replaced by machine guns. So you have it after Gatling and before machine guns. It basically came along just at the wrong time. I really hope we have time to do a full-length video on this because it certainly deserves it. It's very cool. A Gardner gun, to me, is a holy grail of collecting. They're just so darn unusual and so rare and saw so little use. They're just about the coolest thing. Dr. Azar has an incredible collection of early semi-automatic Colts. Here are two of them. So if you're a Colt collector, how about production number serial number 9? That's day one. That's day one production. Now, you may remember in December, we had a Special Army number 9. That was one of the 15, I believe, that were shipped to the Army for trials. Trials are over. It's adopted. This is serial number 9 is produced first day production in December, I believe, 1911. Right next to that, here you have a model 1909. So coming through the pistol trials, you had Colt submit the 1905. They submitted it with some modifications as the 1907. And eventually we're getting to the 1909. I believe there's 23 of these ever made. You're getting some rarefied air for US military collecting and for Colt collectors, one of 23 of one of the most iconic American firearms of all time. That is Holy Grail material. And last but not least, one that you've probably already seen a few videos on if you've been subscribing to our YouTube channel, and you should, if you haven't yet, a Winchester revolver. Of course, Winchester making it for the Centennial Exposition in Philadelphia that year is as rare as it gets. As you know, the gentleman's agreement between Colt and Winchester was to make no revolvers, Colt was to make no lever actions, and so both the Colt Burgess and the Winchester Centennial revolver were never to be. This one, Whitmore Wells, has a really neat extraction device. You can see the lever on the side there. Not the Wetmore Wood, which has the swing-out cylinder and case hardening, which we sold several years ago. This is the Wetmore Wells design. And when you're talking about Winchester revolvers, most of them are tied up in Cody Firearms Museum. And there are a few that are floating out there, and this is one of a handful of Winchester revolvers of a significant collecting genre that is out there. So when you talk about Holy Grails, it might be the best one to stop on. And keep in mind, everything we just showed you was from where I was standing maybe 30 feet away in our preview hall. So all these things, most of them are coming up on day two. And there will be more that are coming up on day three. The Winchester revolver, for example, will be coming up on Sunday. But again, just an absolute powerhouse of things that are coming up on day two of the May Premier Firearms Auction. If you can't come in person, as always, you can search the catalog on rockislandauction.com. Thanks for watching, everybody. Watch me gush about unicorns and holy grails and just being ridiculous in a room full of guns. Thanks for watching, everybody. Till next time, keep your powder dry.